Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Oddballs Behind the Scenes. I am Ethan Banville, of course, co-creator of Oddballs with my good buddy James Rallison, who you all know as the Odd Ones Out. So today I wanted to give you guys start doing some of the full episode behind the scenes and give you some tidbits that were missed along the way, show you some storyboards that you have never seen before, and you're going to see that there are a few things that were left out that didn't make the cut. And some are great, some are a little bit over the top. But we'll have a look and you guys will check it out and enjoy. So, RaisingToasty, this great title card done by Maria Vitan. And of course, this is the James rant, the rant that started it all. And the way it started was exactly what he just said there. Why is there so many toasters? And why is it that no matter which one you buy, they either just barely toast the bread or burn it, like there's no in between. And that was all based off a real conversation that James and I had on Discord. He Discorded me, "Hey, Ethan, have you ever thought about toasters?" And I was like, "No. I mean, I have one. Like, well, what's up?" And he said, "You know, there's no good toaster. Like, how is it that no good toaster has been made when we have all these smart TVs and smart watches and smart everything?" And I was like, oh my gosh, yeah, like we don't have a smart toaster. Like, and we looked and there's like a couple of them out there, but the ratings are all the same. Either it barely burns, you know, barely toasts your bread and you have to push the button down again to toast it another cycle, or it burns your bread. So clearly we needed to write an episode about this, and clearly James had to pursue and try and create a smart toaster, and that's how we ended up with the idea for Raising Toasty. Because it's our destiny. So I turn the music off here so you guys can kind of hear the rant clearly. So now, here's where the difference comes in that you're about to see. So the original rant that we did for James was in line with this, but we had it much more that he was kind of pacing back and forth like a preacher. So, as you can see, we went more in the evangelical preacher angle there, where James was, really, really getting Max pumped up to the point where he suddenly was walking around with live snakes and being at one point touched on the snout by James and fainting as if he was just given the power of God. So, now this is, of course, where we do a flashback of Max's childhood experience. And this is the cue and how it goes in the episode for James asking Max if he could make toast when he was a baby. So, character design in this, Carl Frollo, the other EP on the show, who plays Stuart. He also voices Max's dad, Greg. His mom, Liv, was actually my sister is Korean, and so I wanted to have not only a Korean character in the show, but of course some kids like my nephews who are Korean and Caucasian. So we have a lot of kids of different backgrounds in the show because of that. And I thought they did a great job with them making my sister into a to a mad scientist. And actually, some of you actually have seen the character named after my sister. My sister's name is Jenna, And that's Max's sister's name. So that's where that comes from. So, of course, this is how things went in this one with the boards and how it looked in the lab. So of course you can see that the characters had not been designed at this point. This is just the boards. So this was just the starting point for how this episode, very early on in the process, was going to take shape. Okay, we've had our little montage of the guys trying to train Toasty in their own ways and opposing training ways to make Toasty into a better toaster, but of course it's not quite working, and they pulled him out of the water, and we had the idea, well, here's how it goes in the episode. They put him down to dry off. So he gets mad. However, what do you do with electronics when they get wet? You put them in rice. So in the original storyboards, we put them in rice. And so Toasty went into some rice. And then, of course, listening to them yelling, "He's just a baby boy. The scuba diver's on you." And then Toasty gets angry. And the heat from Toasty actually causes the rice to puff and pop like pop, which my sister used to eat as a kid all the time, just puffed rice. And so, of course, Toasty goes rogue and starts electrocuting everyone on the bed of puffed rice. So there you go. Toasty rice. Now, big ending. You guys know this ending. I'm going to show you what the original ending was, because you guys are going to have your minds kind of blown. And yeah, just watch. And we know that the chip falls into Toasty. Cord goes up, the guys eat. And uh-oh, he's moving. Is it, can it possibly be? Yep, Toasty's back. But not in the original. Now, you also notice that the guys have tattoos in this. Max with his teardrop, even though it was actually James that did the deed. I'm not sure why we gave him the teardrop and not James. That went away, of course. You did not see that in the show. But the guys have their toast still. So there you have it. In the original scripts, in the original boards, the guys did not learn their lesson at all. And they decided to bring a waffle maker to life because, hey, the toaster didn't work out, but surely they could make the waffle maker work. So there you go. So there's some inside stuff for Raising Toasty. And I hope you all enjoyed it. And I hope you guys will come back for the next one. And I will go over episode 2, Breaking and Entering, and how that episode all came about with the there's a good story behind how that phone break story came about and how we ended up going through it and what changed between the boards and the episode.